Hi, this is John with JCB Farm and Garden, and I'm going to be doing a product review of the gear-driven Orbitz water tripod sprinkler. Kind of a long name. Let me show you the product, what it looks like, and then I've never used it before. I'm not sponsored. I'm not paid for this. This is just me sharing a brand new product that I just bought. It's kind of pricey, so I wanted to see if it's worth the money. It was $61 plus tax. I have a tax exempt on it because it's agricultural product, but let's see if this thing works or not. It says it covers up to 80 feet diameter circle. So let's see, because I'm going to try to water my garden with it. I just walked through the garden with a weed whacker and flamethrower to keep the weeds down and the grass and everything grows back. But I kind of like having that grass blanket in there. But anyways, so I don't mind that the grass grows. And so let's hook this up, and let me show you the product first, and then I'll hook it up to the water hose and use it for the very first time. I have not tested it out at all. I don't know if it's going to work or not. It has where you can make like a, you know, a straight forward shot, or you can fan it out, you know, quarter circle, half circle, full circle. I want to do the full circle, set it in the middle and see if it covers my garden, and then I might have to just move it once or twice. So let me show you what it looks like. Okay, so this is what the package looks like on the side of it, and directions on the back. Real simple. It comes pretty much closed flat like this, wrapped up. There's a zip tie holder right here that holds this, and there's plastic on it. Plastic is removable with just yanking on it, and it breaks off. This I rip off. I have not cut the zip ties. Well, let's see what it says. It says right here, 80 feet maximum diameter, six patterns, and that's it. So what it's saying basically is these rings right here turn, and according to how they turn is what we're going to get from the beginning and ending circle. I guess if they're together, we're going to get a full circle or span it out. Let's see. I think this is right here, large, medium, shower, vertical, flat, small. I'm not too sure what all that is, but it's got this little lock wheel here. So we're going to extend the tripod by pulling down, turn this knob right here, which seems to lock it in place, right? Yep, that locks it in place. And here is the water attachment. There is a loose rubber seal with a screen on it right in there that has been falling out. So be careful with that. I don't know if that's just this product or not, but that's right there. And then you have these tripods, which I'm guessing is a double scope out. Yeah, double. So let's go up all the way. We will extend these all the way out like this. Pretty snug. The clips feel pretty snug. And this is seems pretty sturdy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hook up the water hose right here, turn on the water, and let's see what this does. Okay, I got the water hose here, so let's see how easy it is to attach. It's got a little thing here, and just screw on. Hopefully that rubber seal is good enough to where we don't get any leaks. You might want to use a tool, but I'm just going to do it hand tight just to see how good it is. All right, now let's go set this out in the middle, turn it on, see what it does. So the first setting is going to be small, then I'll show you medium, and then I'll show you large. There's also flat and then shower. I'll show you all those patterns, and everything's lined up with that white arrow, including the two separate dials on the bottom that you turn, which is definitely the fan adjustment. So we'll adjust that accordingly. I'm going to turn on the water and see what we have with both of those lined up with the white arrow and on small. Here we go. Okay, so get a little slack here. Whoa. Okay, so these little green notches is where this will stop and turn around and start spinning back the other way. And so it has two of them, and the white arrow right here is the center. So if you have it right lined up with the arrow, where they're that close, you can see that they don't quite push together. That means it's just gonna sit still. So as we turn these and bring them back all the way behind it and line it up, directly behind this white arrow, they are perfectly lined up. This is gonna give us full rotation. What it's gonna do is it's gonna turn around this way, point backwards, it's gonna turn around this way to the same point and stop, covering 100% of the area. That's what I want. Now, that was small. So on the white arrow, we're gonna go from small to medium and see what medium does. So let's take a look. Now, as you can see, I just put a metal rod. It's kind of rusty. It might not be showing up in the camera that well, but I will touch it with my hand. That metal rod is how far it is spraying right there. So I'm going to go ahead again and touch the rod, stand next to it. That's how far out small was. It's now on medium, and I'll move the rod out to medium and then to large to see how far each setting is getting. Okay, now I have a size 17 foot, so 7 of my feet going in one direction, which size 17 is approximately 13 to 14 inches. So heel to toe on the boot. And so that's how much we gained from where it was to the metal spike. So it's giving us approximately 13 to 14 extra feet from going to small to medium. That's pretty good. That's a pretty good jump. It also depends on the wind. I noticed the first measurement that I took was not that far. It was only about 4 feet, but I had a wind gust blowing back. When the wind calmed down, it then was getting me wet and I was getting polka dotted with the water. So not bad. Now I'm gonna go ahead and adjust it to large and turn it on and then see how far large is. Okay, so on shower, it gave me another 5 feet. Not as impressive of a jump, and I wasn't expecting so much of a jump. But one thing I did notice is we do have a slight breeze coming this way. And though it only went 5 feet that way, on this side, it was going over the electric fence. So can the camera see the electric fence? Yeah, you can see the electric fence. So the water's almost going out of view to the right. To the left, not so much. So we're definitely getting more because of the wind of a spread that way. So you might want to pay attention to the wind, breeze, and direction when you set this up, and know that because the wind's coming from my back traveling this way, that this way is going to get a little bit further distance than this way because of the wind. So keep that in mind when you set it up. So far, I'm not disappointed. That's a very large area. Now I've gone ahead and switched it over to shower to see what shower does. So let's turn it on and see what that shower does. Okay, so that was shower, and that shower actually gave me a good 7 foot distance, but what I'm noticing is the circle from the shower, given the wind, is actually covering more ground than the large. And it also looks like it's more of a showering mist than a wider fan. So I would myself go with the shower over the large, medium, or small. So the shower I really liked. The next setting says vert. Vert as in vertical is what I'm thinking. So I just went ahead and switched it over to vert. Let's see what vert does. All right, that was vertical. I'm not impressed. I didn't like it. It reminded me of small, just a lot of mist blowing around. It wasn't an even spray. I really didn't like it at all. Vert, avert, avert, vert. Okay, we now have flat, which is the last setting. So far, it looks like showers it. Really good sprayer, really good pouring rain coming down very evenly throughout the whole spread. That's what I want. I'm trying to water an area, right? Evenly. So far, shower is it, but we have flat. Let's check what flat is. I'm guessing the vertical is going up straight. Flat is going to be more of a fan, I think. Spread out straight fan, like left to right wide. Let's see. All right, well, flat reminded me of vertical, just a little different in the spray pattern, but not much. Covered the exact same amount of area, which was the same as small. So vert, flat, and small seemed to be a little bit more mist in one direction or the other, but really the same thing. Shower, large, and medium are really probably your only three settings as far as I'm concerned with this product. So out of all the other settings, I think the other settings are useless, and that you have either small, vert, or flat. They're all the same. And then you have medium, large, and shower, which almost hit us right here at the camera. So shower is it. Shower is giving us the widest circumference. Is it an 80-foot circle? I think it is. I think it really is about an 80, you know, circumference of a diameter circle. And so I would say, okay, 80 square foot diameter, 80 foot diameter circle. Might be stretching the truth a little bit. Unless you're gonna leave this on for a long time, that outer bank is just not gonna get wet. Everything in the circle, you can almost see like where my shadow is, where my head shadow is right here. That area is really wet from all the testing. So you can kind of see the area that it's doing. Is it good? I think it's good. I think it works. Is it worth $61 before tax? No, I don't think it is. I think for $60, there is another mister that is like a field mister. It bounces off the stream of water and maybe a little bit more pressure. You would be able to cover a lot more area with a lot more water and get the job done better. I think this looks fancy and is most definitely overpriced. Would I buy it again? No, I wouldn't. I'm not going to return the product. I bought it. I wanted to show you it and give you my honest opinion of it. for a lawn area waterer. Sure, it will work. How's it going to do in the garden? I don't know. Judging from the area that it's watering, I think I may have to move this 3 times, which is going to result in a little overwatering, probably in the middle of the garden. So, is it my permanent fix? No. If I'm really busy and have to do something, am I going to set this up and let it water? Yeah, probably. But most likely, I think I might just put it in the goat area with the chickens over here. And that way, I can grow the weeds and the grass that they like. Because goats like weeds. They don't like grass. Grass is a survival food for them. It's a last case scenario. All other food is gone and they're hungry. They'll eat grass. And that's the only time they'll eat grass. So you got to grow weeds. How do you grow weeds? Well, water your yard. Water the garden area. Take a $61 rip-off sprinkler, set it in the middle, and let it grow weeds. And I guess that's what I'll do. I'm John with JCB Farm and Garden. I hope you like this review. Thumbs up, like, share, subscribe. Do a little dance. Turn yourself around. Praise God, Lord Jesus. And we'll see you in the next video. God bless. Bye-bye.